I would like to start my lecture with the praise of Allah Almighty and His last beloved Prophet, Hazrat Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa alihi wasallam. Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, wassalatu wassalamu ala Sayyidul Mursaleen, amma ba'd, fa'uzu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Allah Pak ke naam se shuru jo wahdahu la shareek hai aur jiske misal koi shay nahi, जो तमाम जहानों का रब है, जो हर इब्तदा से पहले भी था और हर इंतहा के बाद भी होगा, जो खुद जारी जिस्म से पाक है मगर हर जगह मौजूद है, जो अपनी ज़ात में पोशीदा और सिफात में जाहिर है और हर शय का खालिक है। अल्लाह पाक के नाम के साथ जिक्र उसके महबूब मोहम्मद रसूलल्लाह सल्लल्लाहु अलैहि वसल्लम का, जिनका नाम अल्लाह के नाम के साथ मिलता है तो हमारा कलमा बनता है, ईमान बनता है, जिनके वजूद को तमाम जहानों के लिए बाइस रहमत करार दिया गया है, जिन पर दुरूद खुद अल्लाह और फरिश्ते भेजते हैं और हमको भी दुरूद भेजने का हुक्म है, जिनकी इताअत को अल्लाह की इताअत और जिनकी इत्तबा को अल्लाह की मोहब्बत हासिल करने के लिए शर्त अवलीन कहा गया है और जिनसे मोहब्बत के बगैर ईमान मुकम्मल नहीं होता। सल्लल्लाहु तआला अला खैर खल्के ही व नूर अर्शे ही हबीबना शफीना सैयदना व मौलाना मोहम्मद व आलिहि व सहाबिहि अजमाइन बिरहमतिका या अरहमुर राहिमीन। आई एम निसार अली फ्रॉम डिविजनल पब्लिक स्कूल एंड आई एम गोइंग टू डिलीवर अ लेक्चर ऑन एसिड्स बेसिस एंड सॉल्ट्स विच इज़ चैप्टर 10 ऑफ क्लास 10। Before delivering my today's lecture, let's have a look at the topics of my previous lecture. We have discussed about the introduction of acids and bases, comparison of the characteristics properties of acids and bases, Arrhenius concept of acids and bases, limitations of Arrhenius concept, and the difference between ionization and dissociation. And finally, we did the practice exercise of that lesson. And the topics of today's lessons are Bronsted-Lowry acid and Bronsted-Lowry base, concept of conjugate acid and conjugate base, and what is amphoteric compound, limitations of Bronsted-Lowry concept, and practice exercise of today's lesson. Now let's start with the Bronsted-Lowry concept. In 1923, the Danish chemist Bronsted and English chemist Lowry independently presented their theories of acids and bases on the basis of proton transfer. So therefore, this concept is also called protoning concept. According to this concept, acid is defined as an acid is a substance, molecule or ion that can donate a proton to another substance, or simply the proton donors are acids. And what is base according to this concept? A base is a substance that can accept a proton from another substance, or simply proton acceptors are bases. Before explaining this concept, first I would like to discuss a common question, and the question is why hydrogen ion is called a proton. As we know that hydrogen atom consists of one proton, one electron and no neutron, and when this hydrogen atom loses its only electron, it will form hydrogen ion, and hydrogen ion consist of one proton only. So what's left behind is just a proton. So that's why hydrogen ion is also called a proton. Let's discuss the first example of Bronsted-Lowry concept, and it is a reaction between ammonia and hydrochloric acid. As you can see in the equation that HCl is a proton donor because it donates its proton to the ammonia. So according to this concept, HCl is an acid. And in this reaction, ammonia accepts a proton from hydrochloric acid. So ammonia is a proton acceptor. So according to this concept, ammonia is a base. So ammonia acts as a base because it accepts a proton, and HCl acts as an acid because it donates the proton. Now let's discuss the second example of this concept. And in this example, I will explain the concept of conjugate acid and conjugate base. This example is a reaction of hydrochloric acid with water, and it is a reversible reaction. In a forward reaction, HCl acts as an acid as it donates a proton. Water acts as a base as it accepts a proton. In a reverse reaction, chloroiodine is a base as it accepts a proton from hydronium ion and is called a conjugate base of HCl. Hydronium ion is an acid as it donates a proton to chloroiodine and is called conjugate acid of water. Now let us define conjugate acid and conjugate base. Conjugate acid is a species formed by accepting a proton by a base. For example, in the above equation, hydronium ion is a conjugate acid because it is formed by accepting a proton by a base water. Now what is conjugate base? It is a species formed by donating a proton by an acid. For example, in the above equation, chloroiodine is a conjugate base because it is formed by donating a proton by an acid HCl. So chloroiodine is the conjugate base of HCl. Now what is conjugate acid-base pair? Conjugate means joined together as a pair. In Bronsted-Lowry terminology, a reactant and product that differ by a proton is conjugate acid-base pair. For example, HCl and chloroiodine is a conjugate acid-base pair because they differ only by proton. Similarly, water and hydronium ion differ by only one proton. So water and hydronium ion are conjugate acid-base pair. According to this concept, an acid and base always work together to transfer a proton. That means a substance can act as an acid only when another substance simultaneously behaves as a base. Let's further discuss the examples of this concept. In these examples, I will give you the concept of an amphoteric compound. It is also a proof that water is an amphoteric species. In the first equation, water reacts with the acetic acid and acts as a base as it accepts a proton from acetic acid. In the second equation, water reacts with the ammonia and acts as an acid because it donates a proton to ammonia. Such a substance that can behaves as an acid as well as a base is called amphoteric compound. For example, water is an amphoteric compound. Now the limitations of Bronsted-Lowry concept. First limitation is that certain substances behave as acids because they do not have ability to donate proton, for example sulfur trioxide or SO3. It means that this concept cannot explain sulfur trioxide as an acid because sulfur trioxide does not have proton to donate. Second limitation is that calcium oxide behaves as a base but cannot accept a proton. It means that this concept is unable to explain calcium oxide as a base because calcium oxide does not have ability to accept proton. Now let's do a practice exercise of today's lesson. And first part is multiple choice questions. Question number 1. When did Bronsted-Lowry give their concept? Option A 1787, option B 1828, option C 1823, option D 1923. And the correct answer is option D 1923. Question number 2. Which one of the following is also called a proton? Option A hydrogen ion, option B helium ion, option C carbonium ion, option D none of them. And the correct answer is option A hydrogen ion. Question number 3. CH3COO- ion is a conjugate base of option A HCl, option B CH3COOH, option C HNO3, option D H2SO4. And the correct answer is option B CH3COOH, means acetic acid. Question number 4. Which one of the following is not amphoteric? Option A H2O, option B NH3, option C HCO3-, option D SO4-2. And the correct answer is option D SO4-2, means sulfate ion. I explained that why other three options are amphoteric. Option A water has the ability to donate as well as accept proton. Option B ammonia also has ability to donate as well as accept proton. HCO3- ion also has ability to donate as well as accept proton. So all three options are amphoteric. Now let's come to the second part, short questions. Question number 1. Define conjugate acid and conjugate base. Question number 2. Prove that water is an amphoteric compound. Question number 3. Why hydrogen ion is called a proton? Question number 4. What are the limitations of Bronsted-Lowry concept? I hope you can answer these questions quite easily.